Okay, so today's project on the garage is to start the wood stove installation. So I'm going to install a wood stove right between the garage door and the window, right here in this opening here. I'll get it all certified. And for starters, you may have seen in some other videos, but I actually bought a small Lakewood Unicorn wood stove off Facebook Marketplace. So this stove is gonna fit right in between over here. And I'm going to build it off the wall, put a little concrete pad just to lift the stove off the ground just a little bit, and get started. So first things first to getting started will be to take off this old drywall, just pull out the insulation, maybe do some measurements, try and center it on the wall where I'd actually like it. Okay, so you can see here I cut my forms to 2x6, so it'll be 5.5 inches high, the platform. So I'm gonna make a square form. It's about 10 inches off the wall that I'm gonna put a heat shield behind it. And I'll make a square and just kind of put it there on the ground. I might put a few pins in the corners, just some screws in the concrete to hold it in place so I don't move it once I start pouring it. But yeah, that's the plan. Okay, so you kind of get an idea here now how the form's gonna go. I'll fill that all with concrete. I'll mix in a bit there. I'll show you how I'm gonna mix it up. So the only other thing I'm gonna do is I might just put a little screw in each corner, kind of just to the ground, so it doesn't move that much while I'm pouring it. You'd hate to have it move, and then you have to kind of push it around after or get it out of square a bit. So I made it about 29 by 29 inches. I think that's going to give me about 1.5 inch reveal around the entire wood stove, kind of just a little bit of extra. But yeah, it'll lift it off the ground just a little bit. Okay, so as you can see, the way I drilled those in, I just kind of drilled in the concrete and just friction fitting some old loose common nails. Nothing too special. It's not actually holding the forms down, it's just going to hold the forms in place. So when I actually go to pour this, I may just put a brick on the corner. You put your first wheelbarrow in, kind of get it around the sides, and then it's in position. It won't really move and shouldn't really lift. After that, you can just top it up. It's not going to take a lot of concrete to pour this, so I'll mix it up and take my time and go from there. Okay, so I've got my concrete materials here that I'm going to mix up. So I swung by Home Depot and got the Sacrete Fast Set. What I was going to do is use the Sacrete Fast Set and the Sacrete Regular Mix to mix it up, but they didn't have any regular mix in stock at Home Depot. So on my way home, I just stopped to get the regular mix at Lowe's. So it's called Quickcrete. So basically what I'm going to do, because it's winter here, we're going to mix one bag of Fast Set to two bags of regular mix. That'll help accelerate it a bit. The other thing to help accelerate it is I'm going to mix in some calcium chloride flakes. So for those of you in concrete, know 2% by massive cement is a pretty good accelerator. You know, these bags are pretty small, so I'm actually probably going to need a scoopful of calcium chloride. And what I'll do is I'll mix this is the flakes calcium chloride. I'll mix it with my water to kind of create a solution that then I'll mix into the concrete. And when it comes to this concrete, how much do we actually need? Of course, I put it upside down. So we need 2.3 liters per bag. So it's actually not a lot of water per bag. So I'm going to need about 12, 15 liters of water maybe to get a good mix, a workable mix. And then because of the size of that I'm doing, I'm going to actually add a bit of concrete stone to my mix just to make it go a little further. So this is a clean, clear, half inch or 13 millimeter concrete stone. And finally, to kind of reinforce it all together, I've got some fibrillated microfiber. So I'll throw a certain amount in, maybe half the bag per wheelbarrow that I mix. I figure I'm only going to get, it's going to take all three bags in one wheelbarrow. To help it along, I'm going to actually go inside and get some hot water. I'm going to have my wife boil up about 6 liters of boiling water to mixed with 6 liters of hot water. That way we can get the reaction kicking off a little quicker. And once the reaction's kicked off there, hopefully it's fast enough that it'll set the concrete before it freezes. It is cold out here right now in Canada. So, you know, we're going to be pouring on a cold concrete slab on top of that. So anything we can do to kick off the concrete, including heating the water, adding some accelerator, mixing some Fast Set with some regular set, will help out. So let's get started.
Ooh, that is getting hard quick. So what I'll do is I'm gonna put a little bit of fresh on here. Watch out, buds.
Okay, so I'm done screeding it off. You can see it's kind of messy right now. The bleed water's coming out of it due to the water cement ratio. So I'm gonna get a level. I've got a lot of working time still left. It is cool outside. I've got a little bit left over here. I might go spread it up around the lean or something like that just to get rid of it. I'll scoop up the stuff around it, get rid of it. But yeah, that's the plan. I'll be back out. See if I can't find my float. Float it, get a level, just make sure it's true. Essentially, and then I might get some tarps and cover it, and I've got a little Melkos heater that I'll put in it just to see help heat it along, and then tomorrow I'll strip it. I'm fairly certain I'll have it'll be warm enough by tomorrow, especially if I put some plastic tarps on it, Melkos heater, maybe throw a bit of that insulation on top just for no reason at all. So the slab's done now, and as I mentioned, I had a little Melkos heater. So what I've done here is set up a little crib with a little workbench there. And the heater's gonna go here, and I'll go get an insulated tarp and throw it over top. And it's just gonna generate enough heat to kick this concrete mix off really, really well. So tomorrow morning, it's gonna be a good, 10 MPa or maybe even stronger, which would be more than enough to set everything on. And there we have it. I've got it double tarped here. It's really, really warm under there now, so I wouldn't be surprised by this afternoon. It's completely set, that concrete. Okay, so after a night of curing, the slab is ready. There's good heat that's generated off of it right now. Since I poured on concrete, there's actually quite a bit of bleed water that came out to it. Came out of the slab, and you can see it all at the surface. And the finish is by no means great, but nearly 100% of this slab is going to be covered by the wood stove, so you won't really see any of the actual ugliness of the slab. So I'll strip it right now, and hopefully it's not too honeycomb. And then I'll maybe start moving the wood stove on top of it. So here's the slab in all its mighty glory. Not the nicest looking slab, but it's a slab nonetheless. You gotta get an idea. The stove will sit on top of it. Because it's still so cool out here, I'm probably gonna set up the heater again and maybe heat it all day today. Again, it's really well set on the top, but you can tell at the bottom it's still a bit green because the concrete floor would have been frozen. But yeah, I'll clean it up. All the little fibers that are kind of sticking at the top there, I'll kind of burn them off with a torch. Beyond that, it's pretty much ready to go. Here we go, guys. The wood stove is in position over top of the little concrete slab here. Little small unicorn, Lakewood unicorn wood stove. That is stiff. I'll have to work that one out. I got one fire brick back there to replace. I've got the double wall stovepipe here. I've got to put my 90 on here. I'll probably kind of frame out where that 2x4 is to put the through the wall insert. and bring it out the back of the garage. But yeah, looks pretty good. Fits nicely. It's gonna work pretty well. Here we have it, guys. I'm ready to install the wood stove chimney. So since I last did an update there, you kind of see I've temporarily installed the pipe here. I just got a piece of wood, just kind of the distance I want. What I did was I basically plumbed the pipe and bored a hole through the wood, the size of those pipes, give or take the measurement that's required. I did install a damper on this pipe, just one of those little cheap dampers. So yeah, it comes through the backside here. And to make it all work, I went to the local Home Hardware here. It's a little hardware store, and they sell the Sentinel series by Selkirk wood stove pipes. And that's the pipes that my brother gave me to install the chimney. So I just basically bought this kit that has the T, the thimble, the holder on the outside, a few little modifications, about one smaller 2-foot pipe to kind of go through the wall to hit the T. But yeah, let's install it. We got all the parts here. I'll have to do some reading. So we got the thimble here. The T is in that box. There's some brackets, some other stuff. But yeah, we'll see how it goes together here. Okay, so it's been a little bit since I worked on this fireplace here. You can see it's all insulated now, and I've just got to put the pipe through the wall. So I'm actually going to drywall it today. But one little thing I did the other day, you can see the fire bricks down here. I had a broken fire brick in the back, and I replaced. So I got 5 new fire bricks in there, replaced the old broken ones. I broke a couple, two of them were already broken. And since I had bought 5 new ones, I may as well use them all anyway. So yeah, the fireplace is ready to go. Essentially, now I'm just gonna install some drywall and maybe get the chimney installed on the outside. But yeah, we'll see how this works. So here I've got the hole through now, the drywall's up. From the outside here, you can see I've got the insert installed. So now it's just a matter of reading the instructions there, I guess putting the thimble through the wall, the insulation and whatnot, and then sliding the chimney pipe through that I've got right here. Okay, so we've got it installed here now. You can see we're gonna hit there, so we're gonna go get a little offset kit that'll offset it, go out and then up again. But looking pretty good for a fireplace install. Looks pretty good on the inside here as well. So one thing I might do is tile the wall there, go get some ceramic tile, tile that wall, that'll make it look a little nicer, then actually put a heat shield behind it. Here we've got the chimney installed now. We've got a bracket up at the top. We're gonna put one more bracket there. But in the meantime, Samantha is gonna actually get a little fire started in here just to get things going. Throw in some cardboard, throw some tinder in there. That's more than good enough, Sam. Throw that and throw the tinder all on top and I'll light it with the torch. Well, here we go. First fire. We'll light her up. It's already, the drop's already going. Good. We'll get a roll in here. Okay guys, a little update on the garage wood stove install here. So as you can see, it's up and running now. We got a little bit of a deer here from the deer season. So this deer here, although not a monster, it's pretty big. It's the biggest one we got on the wintering yard property so far. So this is the first deer that my dad, my brother, and I ever harvested together. We'd never all hunted together and harvested a deer before. My brother and my dad, they had harvested my brother's first buck together. And my dad and I had harvested a buck together one time muzzle loading. but never the three of us together did we get a buck. So my brother shot that buck on the last day of muzzleloader, and let's just say it was like the last half hour, and then we had to track it through the dark to get him, but it was worth it. He's a beauty. My brother mounted it for us. There it is. We were so happy. It was unreal. That there, that's the first buck I ever shot. It's a monster. And this one here, we actually found in the wintering yard this year. We figured it died sometime last year, but it was gonna be a nice buck too, and too bad. But anyways, that was kind of cool. So this is one my brother shot as well. And then my wife's skull is there. There's a roadkill deer there. And then another one my brother shot. So we'll clean all those up and just kind of mount them here inside our little shop garage. But back to the wood stove. We got her going nice there now. She burns nice. As part of the install, I put some heat shield here, just a piece of tin spacer in between. Space at the bottom here so the air it sucks down, what is it, the hot air travels up and sucks the cool air down, something like that. And then same here, we got a heat shield here, same thing, this gets nice and warm, but in behind it stays cool as the cooled air gets sucked down and the hot air rises above it. But that's that, the wood stove. She's beauty hot. It's a miserable day out here today as we're cleaning. Got two dirty dogs. Hey, two dirty dogs. But throw that wood stove on and she's pretty near 20 degrees Celsius. Looks like 17, 18 degrees Celsius. So that's really, really, really nice in here. It's nice to stay warm while you're screwing around. My splitter's in here right now. I just had it in out of the rain. I had it serviced. But yeah, that's that. All in all, I have to say this wood stove has been a huge addition, and I foresee next year's deer hunt around here. This being the meeting zone, we'll get this all cleared out this summer, clean it right up, and then I could foresee every time we're coming back from the deer hunt, we'll probably hang out around this stove and put some music on, just tell stories, have a few beer. But what do you think, Winnie? Winnie, is this a good spot? Hey, is this a good spot? Yeah.